Be very quiet, everybody. We don't want to startle it. It likes the fruit.
I'll go. Huh? What is that?
It is a time that we're entering into when we can be courageous in discussing these things. I would highly recommend other people, if you find these types of alternative fringe ideas, used to be known as conspiracies. Ooh, conspiracies, right? It's not. It's research.
What J-Dreamers does is not research. Looking to J-Dreamers and using him as a source is also not research. At the very minimum, claims should have some sort of backing, a guide to allow you to dig deeper. J-Dreamers offers none of this because there is nothing to offer. All he is talk.
It's looking into things. It's having an open mind. It's being able to balance out what's called fact and your own personal ability to discern what's going on based on your life experience and your knowledge that you've accumulated so far in life. To just continue talking until you feel like you've made sense.
Huh. Irony.
J-Dreamer's original video is over an hour long. If you have been watching my rebuttal from the start, think about how many times I've made this joke you just saw. That should tell you something about the quality of content and the person we are working with here. Even now, as I speak, I am fast-forwarding through J-Dreamer's going on and on about how smart and open-minded people like him are. It would be embarrassing if it wasn't so damn sad. Thousands of people all over the world send money and pay the bills for charlatans like this smug douchebag. He is no different from any other parasite.
Wind and rain did not create that over millions of years. It doesn't matter what kind of magic, you know, you want to throw at it, which it is magic, by the way. When you're taught that in schools, they cast spells. They speak to you in spell form, and they cast a spell over you to have you convinced of what they are instructing you to believe already.
God, the hubris on this guy. School teachers cast spells now? Where do I even begin with a claim like that? Of course, no need for evidence or proof of that claim. Just spewing bullshit out at Mach 3.
Magic.
The bodies of the Titans, not just the Titans, but ancient technology, ancient animals, ancient life forms, all of the ancient world was a part of this. That's an elephant. I mean, come on. Yes, it is a mountain, but it is an elephant as well.
This rock formation is in Iceland. It's funny how all the pictures of this basalt-looking formation always appear to be from about the same angle. I wonder why. Maybe because if you're not looking at this 100% correctly, the illusion washes away.
All of that stuff in the ancient world died, it passed away, and it solidified. Now, giants are real. The Titans are real.
And I base that on absolutely nothing.
This one in particular looks like a big ol', you know. I don't like to say it looks like, you know. But it does look like sometimes, right? I would hate for these types of things to turn into like cloud spotting, you know, where people are just looking at clouds and like, that one kind of looks like this, but it changes 10 seconds later.
It's frustrating watching them be so close to logic and reasonable sense, yet just drift away from it. You know, that the gold ring's there, just grab it already.
These are evident of what they once were. If we decide to look at them in another way, in another light.
That light, of course, being off.
And I'll tell you this much, it makes this boring, horrible, evil, messed up, mundane, destroyed desert of a world a little bit more fun.
It's depressing that J-Dreamers can't be happy with the world as it is. The rock cycle and the deposition of these formations is an exciting thing to learn about. But what that requires is learning, a thing J-Dreamers simply does not want to do.
That's not how any of this works.
And believe it or not, you'll start to find some purpose when you look into it a little closer. And the reason for that is because when you understand your past, your present is filled with purpose. Because now you have drive and a purpose and a reason for what's to come, because you already know what's happened.
I sincerely doubt Jay Dreamers has found any purpose in claiming rocks or elephants beyond the money his poor followers throw at him.
Look, that's a dude. That's a dude right there. You see that arm? You see that, like, gait? That's a dude. That's a face. Man, Mike, come on. That's totally a face.
Seriously, this is what I'm having to rebut. This level of criticism, this level of rigor. It's pathetic. Oh, well, it obviously looks like a dude. Here, let me turn around and show you my bicep. What the fuck?
Now, I want to read to you guys some examples of giants. This book right here is called Giants, Legends and Lore of Goliath. Now, I'm not going to read the book or anything.
Oh, for God's sake.
But I do want to read this particular section.
That doesn't make sense.
This has stories from around the world. All you have to do is lift up these little flags, and it gives you a little story about a factual account of where people have had encounters with the giants of old.
Jay Dreamers is taking his evidence from what amounts to a Christian children's book. Let that sink in for a moment. He is trying to argue that we need to throw out the entire field of geology based on a book made for children with pop-ups.
Island of Tierra del Fuego. Which, interestingly enough, by the way, in the there's this new, like, flat Earth map or whatever going around, high definition, you can zoom in on it or whatnot. In the actual Tierra del Fuego area, it says Land of the Giants in Italian. Okay, it's really interesting. Now, another interesting thing as well.
God almighty, stick to the fucking topic. Jesus Christ.
Before I start reading this, is that movie Pacific Rim, why is it called Pacific Rim? I haven't seen the movie, but I can tell you this, what we call the Pacific Rim, that whole edge of the ocean around the Pacific, where all of the brown people that have the slanted eyes, okay?
You doctor yet?
No, Dad, I'm 12.
Talk to me when you doctor.
That's true, that's where all they're from, okay? That's the Pacific Rim. That is the, what do you call it? The Ring of Fire, right? There is a reason that that movie is called Pacific Rim, and it has something to do with Titans.
No, it has to do with the Pacific Ocean. Watch the fucking movie.
And Titans destroying a bunch of buildings and stuff like that as well. And it's because the Titans terraformed our world. They dug it out, okay? That's why the oceans are filled with water. Because once the flood was introduced, those areas where the Titans had dug out and terraformed, filled with water. Those areas that they were yet to get to are called our continents. Otherwise, everything would just be ocean.
Obvious question here. Where do they put the stuff they dug out if not on the continents? Do they throw the dirt into space?
Tierra del Fuego. The account of the giants. Legends of a cannibalistic giant persisted for many years.
Indeed so. Most indeedly.
Now we have the region of Turkey. In Turkey, it says a one-eyed giant named Tepegos.
Pork chop sandwiches.
Required regular offerings of humans from a nearby city. Now, you'll find out that a lot of times when the...
Wait. That's all you wanted to read? Those two quick little paragraphs? That's the evidence you wanted to disclose to the world? Flip open a little part of a children's book and read a sentence? Oh my God.
Titans are described. They are described as being one-eyed or a cyclops. A cycle-ops. A round eye.
Jay Dreamers takes only what he wants from the myths and legends of giants and titans. If you read up on the myths surrounding the Cyclops, for example, you will see how badly he cherry-picks things he likes from the story to fit his narrative.
The Titans and the ancient gods had unique, particular physical features that were carried in their DNA.
God has DNA. I never knew that.
Okay, so let's go to England. So this is for everybody in the UK. Near Somerset, a group of giants was responsible for burning the villages in the surrounding hills.
Exactly how is that tiny little excerpt supposed to be proof of anything?
Alaska. The Tsimshian people, forgive my, butchering, the Tsimshian people believed that a giant was responsible for giving us sunlight. Now, how interesting is that?
And like,
you're really not that interesting.
I talk about the sun. I try not to take anything in this world for granted, especially the world itself. And what we call the sun, which just means the product or offspring of something, right?
Nope. Wrong again. Feel free to check my sources down below for more information.
This says right here, in Alaskan folklore, that the sun was created by a giant, or a titan. Makes sense to me, especially if it's a nearby and much smaller sun than what we've been told.
Here is an example of the cherry picking I was talking about. Are we to believe the myths of this particular ancient people over others? Why? It's because it suits his needs at the moment. No thought given to finding out the truth, as long as the Super Chat donations keep coming in.
Of pork. Hey, Jessica Williams, thanks. Yes. Let's go to Greece. Hello to everybody in Greece. It was the Titan, Prometheus, who gave us fire. Another reference to a Titan creating the sun? Maybe. Maybe not.
Let's not spend any time actually learning Greek mythology. The truth doesn't really matter, as long as we have those cherries to pick.
We machine harvest most of them, but we do have a U-pick operation, and we have a small pitter that we pit people's cherries if they pick them here and so choose. When you pick cherries, basically you go for color, and the darker the red, the riper the fruit. Orange cherries will not quite, they're not quite mature, they're not quite ripe yet.